It's like Salieri was getting ready to make his move.
Working up to it, maybe. But then Prohibition ended. And the bootlegging business got knocked on its ass. You know, that fighting over booze meant next to nothing. It took us a few years to recover. But when we did bounce back, boy, it was something. We took what dough we had from the moonshine and Canadian whiskey and invested it into new records. Some of them even legal. Construction, restaurants, trucking, gambling. We branched out into everything, except peddling dope. By 35, things were looking up. We had good money rolling in on the regular. I had a wife and daughter. Sam was running a club for the Don. Even Pauly had a few records of his own. Wasn't exactly happy, but what do you call it then?
Content.
Yeah, that was it. And Salieri, he finally starts talking about getting out of Morello's shadow. Maybe buying our own cops, our own politicians.
That's interesting. You think Salieri was sourcing highbinders in 34?
Maybe. Why?
Well, a few years back, the voice squad got a judge on solicitation of a minor. Once in the box, he started confessing all sorts of misbehaving, trying to get a deal. But he copped to taking kickbacks from Morello and your man Salieri. Playing him off one another, trying to goose the take. But once Morello found out, he threatened to bury the judge's kids on the beach, still breathing, of course.
Christ. That was the missing piece.
How's that?
Morello was always winding us up. But he never did anything that might start an all-out war. Learning Salieri was building his own bench must have finally tipped his scales, because in 35, he hit us with both barrels. Of his face and pasted it
hey,
on his face.
Tommy!
Oh, hey, boss, what's going on?
I'm glad you're here.
There you go, boss.
I'm going to Pepe's for lunch, but Carlo called in sick. You up for a drive?
Sure, boss.
Bravo. I'm already starving. You got a piece on you?
Yeah. You think I'll need it?
You know how it is. Things with Morello have been a little quiet lately. Maybe it's just got me jumpy, is all.
A birthday.
So how's
a
business, Tom?
You know how it is. It's good.
Sure, I know the business. I see the books every day. But since what happened, I know that a capo needs to talk to his soldiers without some other guy getting in the way.
And now, back to the musical program.
I guess we're mixing with a better sort of person, though. And I like dealing with all these big shots we got on the pad. Anything's better than those grifters trying to shift their hooch before the 21st went through.
Ah, this is only the start of it, Tom. I got plans. Plenty of good people lining up for a slice.
Glad to hear it.
It's like going for a ride with Pauly. Could we at least try to go in a straight line?
Won't happen again.
Must be nice for you, some time away from Pauly and his cockamamie schemes.
That's better conversation, boss. I'll give you that.
Sure I am.
Me, Sam, and Pauly, though, we're still real tight. We've been through some times together.
Yeah, don't I know it.
Tribune, latest. you taste the cassata, Tom?
Oh. Oh, more wine. Hey, more wine here, please, quickly. You're going to love this wine. It's a... Don Salieri! Welcome, my friend. Welcome.
Good to see you, Pepe.
Yes. Hey, come. Our guest has arrived, eh?
What's on the menu today?
My mother, she would be so honored if you tried her caponata.
Excellent. Bravo, bravo.
Oh, Benny, oh, let me get you a chair for you, huh? Si, please. And to drink, a Chianti. I've been saving this just for you.
Yeah, bene, bene, bene.
Enjoy, huh?
I'm glad you're off the roof, Tom.
Sarah threatened to leave me if I didn't dry out.
I know.
She told you.
No. I put her up to it. Drunkards get sloppy, Tom. I didn't want you to make a mistake we couldn't live with.
For you? And for you.
Pepe, the meal is a masterpiece as always.
Molto grazie, Don Salieri. Praise from such a gourmet as you, it filled me with joy.
Now, you wouldn't call me a gourmet if you knew what I had for supper.
Get down!
Let me finish my wine.
Hey, Salieri! Come out of there and we'll make this quick.
Smoke them out, Joe.
Shit, watch out!
Going out the front door. Can you move?
Not fast enough. We're gonna ambush these boys. I'll keep them entertained while you slip out the back and circle around.
You sure, boss?
Blow them all down, Tommy. Not one of them goes home tonight.
Okay, boss. Be careful.
Tom, just be quick about it.
Cover.
Oh, look at the balls on this kid. You really saved my ass, Tom.
We gotta go, boss. The cops will be here soon.
I need a minute to catch my breath.
Well, let me get you back to the bar.
No, not the bar. We're going to see Carlo. That son of a bitch knew where I was going today, and he calls in sick.
He set you up.
To us, Tom, you could have ended up just as dead.
Yeah, I know, boss.
Carlo's jacked up with some dame in Holbrook. Let's go see what he has to say about all this.
Step on it, Tom. Every minute Carlo's still breathing is a minute that's got me pissed.
Sure, boss.
Can't believe these bastards had the brass balls to wreck my car. Had to be Carlo, didn't it? His pop was tight with Morello right when we started out. Apple don't fall far from the tree, huh? I wept at his funeral. At his sons, I'll be laughing loud. His mom's already a widow, Tom, and now he's gonna make her lonely till the day she dies. For what? Some dough to buy his dope? And my foot through his face. You know what? I'm glad. I'm glad. What's with you driving like a moron? I'm glad this happened. I get to plug another rat, and we finally go to the mattresses with Morello. Today's the day the dam breaks.
Sure feels like it. Why don't you let me go first, huh? Carlo might be waiting for us.
No, Tom. My face is going to be the first and last thing this bastard sees.
What the fuck?
You goddamn dirty grifter.
You better dangle, sweetheart.
It's gonna be a closed casket, Carlo.
You okay, Buzz?
Yeah, just a little one. Let me catch my breath.
Jesus, he's fast for a big guy.
Don't let him get away!
Help! Help me, someone!
Come back here, Carlo!
They're going to kill me!
Hey, we ain't finished with you!
I can explain! Think about this, Tom! Please! Let me talk to the boss! I can explain everything! Tommy, you gotta know! Morello, he was gonna kill Mom! I had to do it! I had to! They made me do it, Tommy! Please! I can explain!
There's only...
Is he still alive?
I'm not sure.
Sergio, how are you? Keeping out of trouble?
Sure. Who's this? Wait a minute. Is that Gordy? It is. Hey, Gordy, how you doing, buddy? Hotly recognized you. What'd he do?
You said you were having some trouble down at the docks, right?
Yeah. It's nothing I can't handle.
Yeah, well, I did some asking around.
This asshole was planning a strike. Strikes are no good for business. Unless you don't want to call him for it, right?
Right.
So I decided the union needed a change in leadership. Is that all right with you?
Of course.
Good. Now, what about that other thing?
That's why I'm here. Salieri's still alive.
God damn it! What happened?
I don't know yet. Crew we sent is dead. Restaurant's all shot to hell.
Stop your crying. Trying to have a conversation here. What about the cockroach Carlo?
Found him with his head smashed in like a fucking watermelon. Never seen anything like it.
So the Salieri must have figured Carlo was the rat. God damn it. Can't even hear myself think.
It's gonna be a war.
I told you to shut the fuck up! We've been at war since we killed Papone. It's just out in the open now.
What do you want me to do?
Make your rounds. Tell little boys to keep their eyes peeled and their powder dry.
Okay. Put the word out.
Hey. Just, keep your head down, little brother.
You too, Don Morello.